Okay, this next video is going to be for the YouTube channel vclevenger, it looks like. Female, Vonda is her name. And we're going to go and make the connection with Vonda. So she has she's allowed permission. She's allowed permission. Everybody else is, sometimes, you know, it's like they have all this protection around people, but we kind of catch them by surprise and we have to wait till everybody's okay with it. So because she's given permission, the universe is in accord with that, and those around her are now understanding that we're here now to do this. So they're now in accord with it. They are saying, okay, whatever. Okay. Like I said, sometimes we catch them off guard, but yeah, we're now doing it. I know it's been a while since she requested it, and I don't always let everybody know ahead. It's only when I get them done that I finally email them and let them know. Okay, so, and I always like to get permission from everybody because I don't want to have interference. I don't want to have deceit, so I want to make sure that we are connecting and doing the best we can. So, now, Vonda, I'm going to ask, is this a soul that's been in her body all her life? If you don't want to tell me, I can look myself. They said, okay, they want me to do it, all right. Okay, Vonda, soul has been in her body all her life. Okay, you have a trail, and that trail is from the time you were born till this time period right now. And if I follow that trail, I can see if your souls come out. I can see the physical trail, I can see the soul trail. And a lot of times I have to teach others that are out in the spirit world how to do this too, from what I've been trained. And I don't mind, because I figure, like, if I'm helping them, they're helping me, and we're all one big family. That's the way I look at it. Okay, so now everybody understands what I'm doing. All right, the next thing I do is I look for the nucleus of your soul. If they've given permission, you've given permission, the universe is all in accord, then I pull a thought off the universe of your soul based on your YouTube channel and your name, information you give me. Pull that off. The first thing I see is a circle with a nucleus in the middle. And when I ask for the first maintained consciousness of the soul, that would be the soul that's right there with that nucleus. And with yours, it comes off as a being of male form. Okay, it's a male form. It's a male form of this planet. It is a male that is of the South American. It's a South American. Okay. Is it coming off as South America? Or is everybody happy with that? Everybody says, as far as they're concerned, it is the area that we call South America. Now, back in that time frame, I do not feel that they were considering that as a continent in your mind. It was a long time ago, in the thousands, okay? Thousands and thousands is what I'm picking up. So, in your soul, thousands of years ago, was a male that was in an area that we call today South America. I really feel it was in, I want to say in the area that we now know of as Brazil, or as close to that as possible. I'll look it up, and if I see that there's something different, I'll let you know. But that's what I'm feeling right now. So a male, you had a primitive Indian looking form, hardly any clothing. Well, that's because somebody was saying that was summertime for you then. So, but in the winter time, you wore more clothing. In this particular moment that they were showing me, you have to remember, in that first lifetime, many years are evolved and many years are there, but a lot of things that we do is just pull off little bits of your that life and get information from them. This particular point in time with this showing that you had, it was a garment of some kind, but very little of it. loincloth, like a little beading around you and stuff like that. So with that, in that sense of showing me that, it makes me think that you had something to do with some type of nobility, some type of princehood or something. Because in that time frame, there was a their kings or whatever had many wives, many children, and I feel that was the situation that was going on around you, that you had part of a big family, and that you were part of that big family, and that you were raised pretty much with the idea that you had means, that you were taken care of and everything. So you weren't being raised to be the king, so to speak, because there was others ahead of you, but because you were like of the baby, you were treated that way, cared for by the other women around. But just, I don't really feel that there was any stress on you. I felt like you got older. You were given some land to take care of, which you did. You had a wife. You had, they said you had a wife and a child, but something happened and I feel like you got injured and then some infection set in and they were doing what they could to, snake. I feel like you were injured, but I also feel like there was something to do with the snake. Was that for the treatment or was that the attack? It was both. You got injured, you had a snake bite you at the same time. I feel like you fell down. I feel like it somehow or another you tripped and then you got bit, and that's one of those circumstances where being in the wrong place at the wrong time. You're walking around and then you fall down and there's a snake and the snake bites you and the snake is poisonous. So you have two injuries. They're taking care of what they figured was injury to the leg and then also the snake bite. They were taking care of you, and as far as that goes, I think that's, you didn't suffer very long is what I'm feeling. I feel like you were there for a while, but you left. That's when you left your life, based on that. But I still feel like you had gotten up in age, and but you had only been married for a while. You only had one child, and then this happened. So, and like I said, because of your breeding, you were well taken care of. Even when you were doing your own thing about, you know, your own little land and things like that, it was just one thing, you know, that, of course, nobody ever expects that kind of thing. But, you know, you just had a really good, I wouldn't say a hard life. You didn't have a hard life. You just had a really good, easy life. I don't feel like you were being snippet or, you know, I mean, if you wanted to be nasty with somebody, you could, but I don't feel like you were mean-spirited. I feel like you were easygoing, and you cared about people, and you were just an observer of things, and just really easy, laid back, taking life easy, just not a care in the world kind of thing. And that's, you know, pretty much your whole attitude. As you got older, you got a little bit more concerned about stuff, and because you were more aware of what was going on. But in the time frame that you were there, I would say overall it was a fairly good one until, of course, that happened. Okay? Anything else we can share with her? No? No? That's it? They said that'll do it. All right. Take care. Bye-bye now.